Today we fired the water disruptor at a working IED circuit. We actually load the disruptor with about 100 millimeters of water and a cartridge at the back. This cartridge provides the propulsion for the water to actually penetrate the IED. Okay, it's actually supposed to cut all the connections at the same time. So what it does is it cuts it so fast, right? The power source, everything gets cut off at the same time, right? It doesn't have enough time to react, so it won't explode. At first, I was a little skeptical. I was thinking that it's probably not gonna cut my circuit, because it's actually packed full of sand, which actually like simulates the explosives. But after I fired, right? Yeah. We have to fire.
Carry on.
Ignited. When I went back, right, everything is spilled all over the place. So I can actually see my detonator, my power source, every wire. They are all like disconnected and spilled all over the place. And the explosives were actually all over the place as well. But the good thing is it didn't actually trigger the explosive. So we can actually retrieve the components and actually see how the IED is actually constructed. So that's the good thing about the water disruptor. Yay. Yeah, this morning I went through a basic crash course on the Mark 8, which is the wheelbarrow. It's actually the remote EOD vehicle. So what we do is, we actually discover an IED where we don't go in the bomb suit straight away because it's not worth it. So we actually use a remote means to actually access the bomb and try to disrupt it. My experience has been very pleasant actually, because whatever we did here is like everything I ever dreamt of. What we do in the EOD wing, right, is actually more dynamic than what I ever faced before. What we actually learned is like the things we could do, then we actually have to like bend the things we could do to like fit the situation well, which is what I actually like, is like more of like applying your logics and all that. I actually want to do very well, like I'll try to aim to be the top for everything, so that whenever like next time I go out as an officer, I can know my stuff to actually have confidence to lead the people that I'm supposed to lead. I should be having my final test called the longest day. To pass this test, we actually have to assess the situation on the ground and to come up with this thing we call the render safe procedure. The easiest way to fail, right, is actually breach of safety.
Activated.
Okay, today's activations, apparently there was a bomb threat. Through some questioning, we found out that some disgruntled employee actually tried to plant some bombs and it is set to go off at 12. As I was making my plan, right, I decided to send my Mark 8 in to actually disrupt the water, use the water disruptor to actually render safe the situation. But as my Mark 8 was approaching the suspected item, right, just about like 3 or 4 meters away, it actually broke down. And there was like no real way that we can actually do anything. So ended up I had to suit up and move into the suspected item in a bomb suit. I considered that the pick stick was actually a hazard, so I decided to turn off the Mark 8 so that the pick stick would not fire off. But apparently that was not enough.
Whoa.
We did talk about the part immediate failure, right?
Uh-huh.
What did you do to cause the immediate failure?
I still tried to mark it and walk in front of the loader.
Yeah.
But okay, so I'm supposed to unload the thing first.
Ah, that's the next question.
So I actually feel quite disappointed, really, because if the Mark 8 didn't break down, right, I wouldn't have gone through all this. My retest will be on Tuesday, and yeah, I'm actually quite nervous, because once I fail this another time, I'm actually out of the course. So I really hope that I can pass the activation. Thank you. Yeah, today I had my longest day reactivation, which is the last chance to actually stay in the course. So the scenario was something like there was a postal bomb. So what I had to do was to actually assess what mode of activation was the postal bomb and how I can actually disrupt the thing. Okay, before we start, right, can I ask where is the item from here?
Oh, that direction.
That direction, 500 meters.
Because on the box, like, got a number.
What number is it?
The phone number or the company. Then you call them.
Doesn't exist.
The company doesn't exist, the guy doesn't exist. Okay.
If this whole building, this part of the building is blocking, right, you can slide it here. Right? Come check. What we ended up was we had a plan to actually send in the Mark 8 robot and do a water disruption without setting the postal bomb off. Okay, so far going very smoothly. Now it's just all the safety issues. I really need to watch safety a lot. It's like now or never already. I nervous also no point already. Just F it. Warren Samuel, ready to fire.
Okay, you do what you need to do.
Okay, igniter number 3.
So I fire?
Yeah, fire.
Did anything wrong?
Yeah, I kicked the battery. Okay, the first round I went there, I saw the battery. Then
after you went to
then I went back. Then I yeah.
That means you have no situation
awareness. Yeah. Okay, I got no excuse. Really, but it's just that I felt that the.
Okay lah. Anyway, you didn't reach anything.
Okay.
Pass.
Okay. 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 Yay! Okay. Ever since the failure last week, right, I don't know, there's this last chance in my head, right, that kept bothering me. But now it's like I finally can take a breather, I guess.
You already commanded course. OCT Sebastian Wong Wei Xiang. Best knowledge for EOD Commander Course goes to OCT Kelvin Ang Ka Min.
When I received the Best Knowledge Award, right, I was actually quite shocked because I can say it's like an affirmation to my hard work, which yeah, I feel very happy about it. I feel like I'm really, really, really very privileged to be in here. It's like the culture, the people, right, is really, I don't think you can find it anywhere else in the whole army. I find that over here, it's like they don't really look at your rank anymore. They look at how you present yourself, how much you know, and how you can actually handle the situation. So I actually really look forward to going to uni because that's where I can finally put my skills to the test and really work in real op scenarios, and through those real operations, right, I can continue growing in my leadership skills and yeah, hopefully do the country proud.